if you go on social media, who do people like get more likes? Jennifer Lopez, Beyonce, Nicki Minaj, Cardi B. We started looking at perfect bodies. We knew what, you know, people like and how to get people's attention. And it was time to go in under the knife.
Dania Placencia died after having a Brazilian butt lift procedure.
When was the last time you had a surgery?
3 weeks ago.
You just had this 3 weeks ago?
The revision? I had this one.
Why do you feel like you need to keep going back to get these surgeries?
Between you and I, it's an addiction.
Women wants to be, you know, they want to be fuller at the top, smaller in the waist, and then they want to come out in the hips like a hourglass or a Coca-Cola bottle.
Is this what you would consider to be like an ideal body image?
Yeah. I wanted more of a slimmer waistline and a more of a bubble-shaped butt.
If you go on social media, who do people like get more likes? Jennifer Lopez, Beyonce, Nicki Minaj, Cardi B. We started looking at perfect bodies. We knew what, you know, people like and how to get people's attention. And it was time to go in under the knife.
As social media fuels demand for a curvier figure, developed in Brazil, the surgery has become one of the most popular cosmetic procedures in the world, but it's also one of the deadliest.
And so where did they take the fat from you?
From my stomach, my sides, my back. To my butt.
Fault Lines traveled to Miami, the plastic surgery capital of the U.S., to investigate what's behind a rise in injuries and deaths related to Brazilian butt lifts. Our reporting uncovered a pattern of high-volume surgical centers that appear to be putting profits ahead of patient safety.
The more they lower the prices, the more people are going to come and bite on it.
Dania Placencia died after having a Brazilian butt lift procedure.
She was perfectly healthy, 28-year-old girl. Perfectly healthy.
In 2019, 28-year-old Dania Placencia decided to get a Brazilian butt lift, or BBL, a procedure that was growing in popularity, especially in Miami, where she lived.
Well, why do you think she wanted to get the BBL?
Sometimes we miss looking a certain way before we had kids.
Her brother says Dania also hoped the surgery would help her at work.
So when she was a waitress serving, she would always tell me, like, Papo, all these girls have mini skirts and they're young. I want to compete with them for tips. I'm getting my surgeries.
For tips.
Just for tips.
On the morning of May 10th, 2019, Dania arrived for her BBL at Mia Aesthetics. She sent her family this photo before her surgery. It was the last image of her alive.
The next thing I knew is that they called saying that she had a respiratory arrest. So we went to the hospital where she was taken from the clinic. And she was dead already.
This video was taken that day.
And that's when we noticed that she wasn't breathing though. And it was that moment that we called 911. I mean, we didn't wait a second.
By 11:55 a.m., Dania was pronounced dead. Dania died of a pulmonary fat embolism, which happens when fat is accidentally injected into the veins, stopping the heart.
And I would never forget going to her funeral. I remember her daughter was still wearing a white dress, screaming to the top of her lungs for her mom.
Did you wish that you had talked to her about BBLs, or did it even change your thoughts about your own surgery?
If I would have said that, I would have been a hypocrite because I was going in the next week. She died a week before my surgery, my second surgery. And you know how it is. You pay for all that money. There's no refund. There's no refund.
And how many friends do you have that have had BBLs?
All of them.
All of your friends?
All my friends have had BBLs.
Despite the potential complications, the popularity of the surgery continues to grow.
This is where they stuck a stick about this long into the butt, into there.
When was the last time you had a surgery?
3 weeks ago.
You just had this 3 weeks ago?
The revision? I had this one.
Why do you feel like you need to keep going back to get these surgeries?
Between you and I, it's an addiction.
It's an addiction?
It's an addiction. It's like when you start gambling, you're just not going to stop. So I'm gambling with my body to get the perfect body.
Many cosmetic surgery patients in Miami come from out of state, lured by the clinic's cheap prices. Sheila Powell, who lives in Mississippi, was one of them.
You can see those scars right there.
In 2018, she decided to get a BBL ahead of her wedding day.
And I had for a long time been dieting and doing different things to try to lose stubborn fat, and I just couldn't on my own. So, you know, social media made it seem like it was easy, it was convenient, and it would give me, you know, those instant results that I needed.
Sheila went online and found out about a clinic in Miami called Seduction Cosmetic Center and booked an appointment there with Dr. John Sampson.
Oh, look, Valentine's special, Brazilian butt lift for $112?
A month, uh-huh.
Before and after. And that's him, right?
That's Dr. Sampson.
Sheila drove 13 hours for her surgery, bringing along her twin daughters, who were 16 at the time.
Were you worried about it for her at the time? Did you think there were any risks?
We're going on a trip to Miami, that's all we think. See the palm trees and beaches, you know.
On the morning of February 23rd, 2018, Sheila and her daughters arrived at Seduction for her appointment.
When I got there, they took me to the bag and started prepping me for surgery, taking my blood pressure. They put me in a room, and Dr. Sampson came in there and talked to me.
And that's the first time you had met him?
Mm-hmm. First time.
And what was your impression of him when you first met him?
Kind of seemed really rushy and kind of seemed just, you know, straight to the point, you know. And I remember asking him about lipo in my arms. He said, we'll do whatever, you know, you want to pay for. That's what he told me. I remember, like, going in, like, the surgery room and the anesthesia doctor coming in. And he was like, I'm going to be the one putting you to sleep. I remember it was just me and him in the room. And I was like, where's everybody? And the next thing I knew, I was asleep.
Sheila's chest cavity was punctured during the liposuction portion of her procedure, collapsing her lung. She was rushed to the emergency room of a nearby hospital.
What was going through your mind when you saw your mom being taken out on a stretcher?
It made me emotional because when I asked, nobody knew to tell me anything.
It was scary, huh?
My feelings just so hurt. It's like just a blink of an eye, I could have lost my mom. And I could have been in Miami by myself, not knowing where, how to find her or anything.
Oh, gosh. You still have a scar. Oh, my goodness. Look at this. So this is the scar that's remaining. This is from the surgery.
Mm-hmm.
Sheila spent the next week in the hospital with her teenage daughters sleeping beside her.
I look at Sedusha as a chop shop, because they definitely don't care about their customers, their clients. It's just all about the money. They want to make the fast money, and they just do it really, really quick and get you out.
Sheila sued Seduction and her doctor, John Sampson. The case is still being litigated in court. In 2021, a 33-year-old woman died while Dr. Sampson was performing a Brazilian butt lift. An investigation by the Florida Board of Medicine, the administrative body which governs the practice of doctors in the state, revealed it was his seventh patient of the day.
There's evidence that fatigue plays a role, and I think that's something that he should have thought about, to start an elective surgery. That's the most dangerous cosmetic surgery in the United States, at 8:30 at night after having operated all day.
He was ordered to pay a fine and was permanently banned from performing BBLs in Florida. As for Dania's case, her surgeon, Dr. Alvarez, was fined and banned from performing the procedure for 1 year. Meanwhile, in response to the rising deaths, the Florida Board of Medicine took action by creating an emergency rule.
This basically limited the number of BBLs that a surgeon could perform to 3 a day max, and also required them to use an ultrasound during the procedure. And that emergency rule was only good for 90 days, by the way, so it's expired.
But Dr. Alvarez and other surgeons formed a lobbying group called Surgeons for Safety to protest the order, and they sued the Florida Board of Medicine.
They said we shouldn't limit doctors on how many of these they can do, and we shouldn't have required them to use ultrasounds. And part of their argument was that, if we keep these rules, you're going to drive patients to the doctors who don't follow the rules. They are also, they've become pretty generous donors to the Republican Party of Florida and to Republican candidates. So during the time, within like 6 months, I want to say in the first 4 or 5 months, they donated about $350,000.
Members of Surgeons for Safety did not respond to our request for interviews. With the emergency order now expired, the Florida Board of Medicine is trying to pass new safety regulations. Meanwhile, state lawmakers passed a Republican-sponsored bill that requires more oversight on how BBLs are performed, though it doesn't include a cap on the number of surgeries a doctor can do per day. But what happens at these high-volume clinics goes way beyond Florida.
This happened here in Miami. It began here in Miami, but unfortunately, it's not restricted to Miami. And that's for two reasons. That number one, patients from all over the United States are coming here, and they have had these complications and deaths. So it is affecting the entire country. What we have also found is that many of the clinics that have started here in Miami are now franchising. And I think every community needs to understand that when a clinic opens up, the business model is incredibly important.
How did Dania's death affect Dr. Alvarez's business?
I don't think it affected his business. As a matter of fact, he expanded his business.
Wow, look at all these. Austin, Atlanta, Baltimore, Chicago, Dallas, Houston, Las Vegas, Miami, New York City, Tampa Bay.
So many that Dr. Alvarez apparently cannot keep track of how many patients have to be transported to the hospital with complications.
We are 13 centers with thousands and thousands of cases, so I can't remember every time a patient.
And I'm not asking you every time, I'm just asking you, in the history, has it been more than 2 or 3 times that?
I don't know.
In 2021, the Texas Medical Board investigated Dr. Alvarez when 3 of his patients developed complications after their surgeries that required them to receive emergency care. They found that he failed to timely respond to those patients and did not maintain adequate medical records. According to a receptionist at Mia Aesthetics, Dr. Alvarez is no longer performing surgeries.
They become so desensitized that they see it as a piece of meat instead of a human being.
I thought I was in good hands. I thought I was with one of the best cosmetic doctors. I thought that I was gonna come out of there looking like an hourglass. I don't think he valued human life. I think it's all about money. All about money.
Dr. Sampson did not respond to a list of questions we sent him. According to receptionists at Seduction and Dr. Sampson's private practice in Michigan, he's no longer performing BBLs.
Go get KJ. Check KJ camera.
I live every day like it's my last day because I know that I could not have been here. But I feel like God just allowed me another chance to be here with my family,